Welcome back to the Rhode Show. When the University of Rhode Island's football team was paired up with an unlikely teammate, their lives and his were changed forever. Meet Evan Hudden. This amazing, outgoing 13-year-old from Warwick was diagnosed with spinal bifida at birth and also suffers from hydrocephalus. Over the summer, he was drafted number one to the Rhodey Rams roster, and team's impact has been outstanding. I got a chance to catch up with Evan, and he told me about how he feels about one of his teammates.
I literally look up to him, literally, because he's too tall.
About this incredible story is the friend and mentor he was talking about, the URI football's defensive end, Shamari Watts. Good morning, Shamari.
Good morning, Sam. How are you?
Great. So great to be here. Thank you for joining us.
No problem.
So Evan is such an amazing kid. I just have a couple questions about his experience with
you.
So when Coach Trainer first approached you and told you that your senior year, you were going to be the mentor for Evan Hudden, what was going through your head?
I kind of didn't know what to think. I had never been put in a position where I had the responsibility of being a mentor for a young man. And I grew up in a house with all females. I have two sisters. So I was kind of open to the whole situation, and I'm glad it happened because me and Evan are like this.
So. Yeah, he told me he's so awesome. So the day that he was drafted number one. What was that like for a team, like as an experience overall?
I mean, we were excited. We were geeked up. We were glad to draft Evan first overall, number one. And it was a great day. I mean, we had pizza, we had drinks there and everything. And Evan kind of showed his personality early. I mean, he's such a great kid. He's such a phenomenal kid. And everybody kind of embraced him and embraced him in our family. And now he's one of us.
And so you and Evan obviously are very close from just talking to you and meeting Evan and his family, who are so grateful for that you're in his life. So what are some things that you and Evan do off of the football field?
We FaceTime, we email. We emailed pretty consistently throughout the season. And I talked to him over Thanksgiving break. We just went on for Thanksgiving break. So I talked to him a good amount, and we FaceTime a good amount. And I got to meet his entire family, his grandparents and everything. And just seeing his face light up when he sees me on the other end, it just makes my day, so.
Yeah, absolutely, and you sure make his day. He was actually texting you when I was there.
Yeah.
He was like, I want you to meet someone, because we hadn't met. And so what do you think of Team Impact as a whole, bringing Evan into this situation?
I think Team Impact's great. I think anytime you're gonna take a young man, whether he has special needs or not, and link them up with older people who kind of have their life on the right track. I mean, we're all football players. Most of us are on scholarship, so. That's always a good thing. You always want a role model or somebody to look up to, or a group of people to look up to, so that you kind of know the right things to do and how to be successful.
Okay, and so the draft day, back to that, he was drafted number one. That was the most exciting day of his life. He actually was wearing his football jersey
when I went to his house,
and he showed me the football that you guys all signed.
Right.
And he showed me where you signed it, because he has it memorized
right now.
So you're obviously his idol. What was it like to have Evan cheering for you on the sideline?
It was great. I mean, so you have so much emotion going through your body during a football game, and sometimes whether things are going well or whether things are going bad, you kind of need a relief, and like, to go and see Evan and just give him a high five during the game, it just really meant a lot to not only me, but the rest of my team.
Yeah, absolutely. It meant a ton to him, too. And so if you had the opportunity to do this all over again, would you?
Absolutely. I mean, I kind of wish I can go back to draft day and just go through the whole process all over again. Like I said before, Evan's such a great kid, and he's so genuine, and we kind of embraced him with open arms, and we're glad he's a part of our family.
And was there one memory that maybe stuck out for you from this season?
I just like any type of one-on-one time I can get with him. I mean, FaceTime, it's kind of, we can relax. We don't have to, you know, be too formal, but I can't speak enough about the guy. He's just, with all the adversity that he's going through in his life and everything, he was a perfect fit for our team, and he's just such a great kid, and I'm glad I got to meet him and I got to know him.
Absolutely. So his dad was actually talking to me about one of his favorite memories of Evan, which there is a picture of that's on your Facebook. Mm-hmm. It's when you were playing Brown University. Mm-hmm. It was a tough game.
Yeah.
And Evan was on the sideline cheering you guys on, and you had your head down, and his dad said he watched the entire thing, and his mom got it on camera.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
She did.
And he wheeled over to you and put his hand on your shoulder, and he just said it was probably the most breathtaking thing about the entire experience.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't really notice when it happened because we're in the flow of the game and everything, so I always check with him a couple times throughout the game, but when I kind of looked back and looked at the picture, I kind of saw how powerful it looked, and it kind of explains me and Evan's relationship. I mean, he honestly, every time I see him, it's a pick me up. He picks me up. No matter what I have going on throughout the day, I like to keep contact with him because of that very reason. I mean, he's great, and I really can't say enough about him. I'm just so happy that we have the relationship we have, and I know that we'll be friends for the rest of our lives.
So. And that picture is actually worth 1,000 words. It's
absolutely
an unbelievable picture. So, Shamari, thank you so much for being
here. Thank you so much for having me.
It's awesome to have you and learn about the organization. If you want to learn more about Evan Hutton's amazing experience, we'll post more information on our website. Just head to WPRI.com and click on The Rhode Show.